Hello, everyone. First of all, thanks to the organizers for giving me an opportunity to talk. And today I will be discussing about our ongoing research project, unraveling the role of root cap in shaping the plant responses to salt stress. So root cap is an organ which is present at the very end of the root, consisting of the columella cells and the lateral root cap. So when a plant root is growing in the soil, it is basically penetrating into the soil. And it is this root cap region which is exposing to the external condition first time. And the root cap is a fantastic organ to study in terms of development as well as physiology. And when we talk about the physiological responses, it's already known to have some role in many trophic responses. For example, the gravitropic responses shown by the roots are due to the presence of stratolith molecules in the columella cells. Also, they have some important role in the positive hydrotropic responses, that is the plant roots try to grow towards the water. And another important tropic response, which is getting much attention in the last few years, is the halotropic responses. That is the plant roots try to grow away from a high saline conditions. So what makes this root cap so special in sensing this environmental stimuli, or how they are perceiving the signal from outside? In order to address these questions, we decided to look into the proteins which are present on the root cap when the plant is undergoing any abiotic stress conditions. And in today's talk, I will be focusing more on the salt stress. So in order to do that, we decided to do a cell type specific proteomics or a root cap specific proteomics under the salt stress using the FACS, which is fluorescent activated cell sorting, and the LC-MS analysis. So the first thing to do for this particular experimental design is to develop a plant which is having GFP tag only on the root cap cells. So we done that by tagging a root cap specific promoter with GFP. Then we used this particular plant for giving the stress treatment, here the salt stress. Then the root tips were collected and the protoplasts were isolated. These were then subject to the FACS sorting. So the FACS sorting basically helps us to separate the GFP positive cells and the GFP negative cells. Here, the GFP positive basically represents the root cap cells, and the GFP negative cells represents the non-root cap cells. Then the proteins were extracted from both the samples separately, and then they're subject to the LC-MS analysis. So the challenge here was to get a minimum number of 50,000 GFP positive cells per replica in order to get a good amount of protein from each of these cell types. So in order to get that, we have to start with a very large number of seedlings, approximately 16,000 seedlings per one biological replica. But we could successfully do that. And from the very brief analysis of the proteins in the root cap and the non-root cap cells, the geo-enrichment shows that upon the salt stress in both the cell types, the proteins are enriched for the response to salt stress. Also, it shows that in the root cap cells, there are many terms enriched compared to the non-root cap cells upon the salt stress. So this shows that the root cap is more active upon the salt perception, and it might be trying to relay the signal into the internal gene regulatory network of the root. So this observation becomes more clear when we look into the interaction network of the proteins in both the root cap and the non-root cap cells. The proteins present in the root cap cells are very actively interacting with the proteins which are present in the non-root cap cells as well. A further detailed analysis into our data, we try to look into the proteins which are exclusively present or exclusively absent in the root cap cells upon the salt stress. And here we could, so this is the best way to find new candidate genes which might have some role in regulating the root salt stress responses. And we could see many genes, already known genes, which have some important role in the iron transport upon the salt stress, but there were some unexpected new candidate genes as well in this particular list. And one among them was mannose binding Jacquelin-Doolittle lectins. So we had a look into what are this Jacquelin-Doolittle lectins, and our survey in the Arabidopsis shows that there are 50 JRLs present in Arabidopsis. And among that 50, 10 of them are very specific to the root cap cells. So we validated this data by choosing one of the GRLs, which is GRL10, using a promoter reporter expression line. And here we could clearly see that, yes, they are very specific to the root cap. Not only that, they are responding to the salt stress as well. So we had the knockout lines. Also, we developed the overexpression lines for the GRL10. And here in the control condition, you could say that they are all growing very happily and very similar to the wild type. But upon the salt stress, you can see that the GRL10 knockout is having some advantage over the wild type and the overexpression. The average primary root length and the average number of lateral roots are more for the GRL10 knockouts compared to the wild type and the overexpression. So overall, our study indicates that the GRLs are novel and strong candidate genes, which might have some role in regulating the salt stress responses in the root cap. And in future, we would like to some more root cap specific proteomics under other abiotic stresses. Here we have chosen the heavy metal cadmium stress in order to find more new candidate genes, which might help the plants, which might help the plants in order to overcome this abiotic stress conditions. Also, we would like to see what exactly is the role of GRLs under the salt stress. So we want to give more attention to the signaling or the mechanism of these GRLs. Also, we want to have a look at whether the GRLs are also responding to other abiotic stresses as well. So we will be looking into the behavior of these GRLs under the cadmium stress. So by looking into the landscape post proteins present in the root cap under the abiotic stress and elucidating the role of GRLs, our study, we will be able to reveal the importance of the role root cap plays in helping the plants to survive this abiotic stress conditions. With this, I would like to acknowledge both my supervisors, Dr. Ishwar Ramireddy and Dr. Katya Vitsal, and all my colleagues at the Plant Functional Genomics Groups at ICER Tirupati for their kind support. And thank you everyone for your kind attention.